All right, for a second I was thinking that it might not fire as there weren't too many people in the queue. Anyways, we have no lands, so we're gonna mulligan. And yeah, this hand looks pretty great. We are on the draw. Can't really imagine putting Meddling Mage in the bottom, like in the dark, so I'll keep it for now. Inquisition of Kozilek. That's annoying. Well, there goes our Bird of Paradise. All right. So I'm not going to lead off with Forest. I'm just going to go ahead and play Misty Rainforest, get a blue-white land. Hallowed Fountain. Our opponent being on Fairies. Oh, I wish I was on the play. I could name Bitter Blossom. All right. I don't even. It's like a good card to name. This deck should have Gitaxian Probe in it. There's Spellstutter Sprite. And, like, Cryptic Command. I'm gonna name Spellstutter Sprite. That's generally a four of in these decks, so. Could also name Cryptic Command. That card is a card that could easily be like, a two or three of in these type of decks, because you also want to play like Mistbind Click in your decks. Double Inquisition. Right, Scavenging Ooze was not bad. Let's go ahead and attack here. Their opponent just gonna play a Snapcaster Mage. I'll go for the throat. Okay. Do that. And our opponent could have Snapcaster Mage. I'm debating whether or not I want to just kill the Go for the Throat. Yeah, I'm gonna go for the throat, the Go for the Throat. I don't even. You guys know what I was trying to say. But like, it's awkward because if my opponent just passes there, like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Like, I want to grow my Scavenging Ooze, maybe, but. If I do, then my opponent can kill in a response. Scavenging Ooze seems like a pretty reasonable threat here. Ooh, I do not mind the Eternal Witness. If my opponent's going to opt to block, nope. And now I have the option of making a larger Scavenging Ooze. I suppose I could have cast Eternal Witness, but if I cast Eternal Witness and my opponent casts Spellstutter Sprite, then I can't even attack because then my opponent will just block with the scavenging with the fairy plus the Spellstutter Sprite. So I guess I just I mean if my opponent has it, I should still draw it out, I think, because resolving Collected Company seems more important. It's also possible my opponent just doesn't have anything. All right, definitely want the land here. Scavenging Ooze got Vapor Snagged. Okay. Let's do that and pass. Our opponent's running out of gas, but this Bitter Blossom is going to be problematic. Ooh. Our opponent's deck is fancy. All right. Probably want a blue-green source here. We're getting pretty low. I even attack here? Think so. So our opponent's going to block. I should probably just get a basic so I don't take damage off the Horizon Canopy. I think I'm going to go for a Collected Company on my opponent's upkeep. Opponent only has one card in hand. I think I play two forests. I probably want to get that. I'm going to do it now so I don't get spells that are sprited. Let's see. Do I need multiple? I already have two blue sources. I don't think I need a third blue source. And I don't think I need another white source. So yeah, I'm going to go with forest. And cast Collect the Company. See if I hit some Reflector Mages. Alright. That wasn't that great. I guess Voice of Resurgence is pretty good. And I don't think, I think I'd rather have Eternal Witness than Meddling Mage. Although Meddling Mage is a 2-2 body, that's not irrelevant. What am I Eternal Witnessing back? I guess a Reflector Mage? Yeah, I guess that's just better. Reflector Mage, you know, kills a fairy. Not the worst. Hitting the Voice of Resurgence, though, was very nice. Second Bitter Blossom. Aggressive. Are these getting in there? Nice. Okay. So instead of casting Collect Company, I think I just want to play the Reflector Mage here. My opponent doesn't have any creature lands, so let's see. Play this, Reflector Mage, blue, white, goes quarter. Kill this Fairy Rogue. Play a Scavenging Ooze. My opponent has a counter. It's pretty nice just because we have the voice in play. Let's attack. All right. Double Bitter Blossom is pretty good, but our creatures are pretty large. So now because we have a Voice of Resurgence in play, if we do plan on casting Collect the Company, it's better to just do it on our turn. The only way our opponent wins is by attacking with the fairies here. I don't know what else they have, though. Scion of Una, is that played in the fairy decks? I don't even know. Let's see. If I'm on the play, would I keep Meddling Mage? I don't know. All right. Let's just remove the creature, gain some life. Ooh, another Scavenging Ooze. All right. So, what can our opponent choose to do? Our opponent has to block the Scavenging Ooze. So, my opponent's likely blocking Scavenging Ooze plus Eternal Witness. Now, I'm trying to see, like, if I collect a company, will I be able to find more good cards here. Yeah, I'm going to just run out the Collected Company here. So green, green, Ghost Quarter, and Hallowed Fountain. My opponent opting for a Spellstutter Sprite. So my opponent has, like, our opponent has to kill us next turn. Attack with everything. Our opponent's going to go down to one life next turn. All right. So our opponent is currently at 3. Going to go to 1. I'm not going to play the Suze. I think I'd rather be able to gain an additional life. So, like, yeah, I think that's actually relevant in case my opponent has a Scion of Una. Because if my opponent has a Sign of Una, we would just die if we just tapped out and played Scavenging Ooze. But as is, like, it's going to be hard for my opponent to actually be able to survive with two Bitter Blossoms in play. All right, so that was game one. How do we board against this deck? Well, I think Meddling Mage is pretty bad. I think Casali Pride Mage, I'll bring in the Reclamation Sage too, just to have more answers to Bitter Blossom. Intrepid Hero seems pretty poor. Kitchen Finks isn't bad. Stony Silence, Kataki are both pretty bad. Mana Leak could be good. I don't think I like Relic of Progenitus. Let me see what else is bad here. I like Reflector Mage. Just having a way to bounce a token. It's a good creature with Collect the Company. Vendilion Click doesn't really match up well. Like, you don't want creatures that have one toughness for the most part, because they just get blocked by Bitter Blossom tokens. And you have to assume that they're going to have some number of tokens in play. Like, the reason why I like Eternal Witness is they'll still be able to just get back a large creature. So now the question is, do I want Dispel or do I want Mana Leak? My opponent didn't show any Snapcaster Mages, so I don't think I just bring in Relics in the Dark. I do have a couple of Scavenging Oozes already. You know, on the draw, I think I just... Well, let's see. Do I want Dispel? Probably have Cryptic Commands. I don't know. You know what? I'll just go with Mana Leak. Thinking about it for a while, but I'm still just going to go with Mana Leak. Let's see if I want all of these removal spells too, actually. It's possible I just want both. Cut, like, Dismember. Yeah, you know what? I actually think I want both the counter spells. I'm wondering how much of this I want. Like, they probably have Mistbind Click. I probably want to kill the Mistbind Click. But, like, that's the only creature you actually want to kill. Nothing else really matters. All right. I'll try this. All right. This hand's got a Voice of Resurgence in it, so I'm going to keep. Creeping Tar Pit, okay. Let's go with blue-white. So I can go blue-white, turn two Voice of Resurgence, turn three Kitchen Finks. The most fair hand in all of Magic. There's the Bitter Blossom. I've been pretty underwhelmed by Bitter Blossom. Like, I tried playing Fairies when Bitter Blossom was first unbanned, and I thought it was going to be potentially good, and I don't know. It's pretty embarrassing compared to cards like Lingering Souls and, I don't know, just a lot of other cards. I will give props to my opponent in that they have a very, very sweet deck. Everything is foil. Opponent opting to Thoughtseize us. I wonder what they take. Like, Reflector Mage is pretty annoying here. I just add to my board, kill a Fairy Rogue. But I mean, all of my I don't mind this Thoughtseize just because all of our three drops are pretty strong here. Our opponent getting rid of Knight of the Reliquary, River of Tears, into another Hand Disruptions. Oh no, just attack. All right, I'm okay with that. I'm not gonna trade. I think Voice of Resurgence is too valuable, and I don't mind trading damage here either. Like. All right. I don't think I need to bounce right now, so I'm just going to attack. And I'm going to play Kitchen Finks because it's larger. I'm going to fetch a basic island here and play Kitchen Finks. I just, you know, you have the spells. I already can cast everything in my hand. But next turn, like, being able to play Reflector Mage plus the spell is pretty nice. Unless my opponent plays a Spellstutter Sprite, which would be annoying. But I feel like my opponent would have kept up Spellstutter Sprite last turn. Well, no, maybe not. Maybe they didn't have enough fairies in play. So four mana up. Mistbind Click. Oh, this is the awkward part, though, right? Like, you play Mistbind Click, and I still just get a creature. Yeah, Mistbind Click resolves. I suppose my opponent can try to tempo us out here. Ooh, that was a good draw too. Anyways, no interest in attacking here. But yeah, I mean, we're going to be able to outrace this flyer, I think. I mean, even casting a Reflector Mage, let's see. That creature's owner can't cast spells with the same... Wait. Until your next turn. Oh, my opponent can kill it still. Okay. That's how that works. I can either cast a Collected Company or a Reflector Mage. I think I want to cast Collect the Company. Ooh. Look at that. All right. We're going to go Reflector Mage. Is it Eternal Witness here, or is it Phantasmal Image? Because all I want to do is just bounce the Mistbind Click. And what does the Eternal Witness get me back? I guess Eternal Witness doesn't really get me back a whole lot, like Knight of the Reliquary or Phantasm. So I get Reflector Mage and Phantasmal Image. And... Oh, so you can't copy the Reflector Mage because it comes into play at the same time. Interesting. All right. I'll just make... Voice of Resurgence. Yeah, I think having two voices is pretty great against the fairy deck, where it's just trying to do everything at instant speed. But there you go. There you go. My opponent got to play turn two Bitter Blossom, Hand Disruption Spell, Mistbind Click, and it still wasn't very close. One thing to note from that is just probably don't play fairies. I remember the Pro Tour in Washington, D.C., Guillaume Matignon, you know, we all had played various decks for that Pro Tour, but Matignon was like, came with this fairy deck and was just like, yeah, I'm going to play it. And I was like, are you sure this deck is good? He's like, no, this deck's probably bad, but I'm still going to play it. It's like, you know, sometimes you're just a blue mage no matter what. Kind of the same as Mr. Waffle Tapa as well. They're both masters of playing control, and it's like, just play what you like to play. But that was round one, and maybe we can go 4-0. 4-0. Go for it. Go for the gold.